Hello everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Heroes. It is indeed the big day, or actually, I am recording on the big day at least. We are here for the very first banner of Fire Emblem Engage, the new game that is coming out, or actually has already come out by the time I release this video, but it is coming out on the 20th and it is really soon from when I recorded the video, basically a couple of days. So today we are here to get the very first characters that arrived with the very first banner. We have of course the protagonist, and then we have one of the four lords, plus his sister and one of her retainers. It is a pretty good combo in my opinion. So as you can see, I was very charmed by Three Houses on a particular character, as you can see by the four Hildas in my home screen. Which character am I enamored by Engage so far? Well, actually I have a couple. I have way more than Three Houses, to be honest, because I am one that really enjoys Mika Picasso designs. I played Fate Grand Order for a very long time, basically 5 years or so, and whenever I saw her designs in the game, I really liked them. So whenever I saw that there is a full Fire Emblem full of her designs, well, I actually thought to myself, I want all the characters. If I had to go on specifics, however, for the girls I really like Hortensia and Yunaga, plus also Alear, of course, since it is the main lord, but the main design in general, but I always try to mix it up with a couple of characters. For the boys, I like Diamant. I think that also that is voiced by everyone's favorite archer is really cool. And then we have some other characters that I like in Zelkov, I believe he's called. He's actually quite funny in his dialogue, if you guys saw the Japanese Twitter trailers that they did over time. And then also another one, let me think of the names, because it's kind of hard to forget names whenever they post them in Japanese and then you have to translate them into English and there is some sort of difference. He's named Bune, I think. He's a chef from the Sand Region. I actually like chef characters a lot. Whenever I played Final Fantasy XV and we had Ignis, it was one of my favorite characters whenever you got ingredients, so I actually like those type of characters. So you will see me rolling for Engage Red Ups for sure in the coming future, especially if we get some really cool ones. Which characters did we get from Engage? So as I told you, those four plus Eddie, which is a free character that you get just for logging in plus doing some challenges, and actually I already kinda have her prepared for a showcase really soon. There she is. I also love that they gave her abdominals on the art here in 3D. They actually don't show really well, but they have it here. I also gave her Lul Attack and F3, which is kinda premium and nice. I want to make sure that actually value the engaged characters a lot more so that we get more red ups out quicker. And then you have Lumera, which is the Grand Hero Battle for the game, the first one at least. Lumera is actually one of the best Grand Hero Battles, if not the best, that we've gotten in a very long while. Null follow-up, swift stance, personal weapon, which is actually crazy. You can get a really solid character out of Lumera for sure, and I will also put a favorite on her, so I remember. On the banner, instead, we have the four characters that I told you guys. It's actually a very good deal because you can get 10 free pulls on this banner, so in general you should be able to get plenty of characters. I am aiming to get Alear, Celine, Alfred and Chloe in this order for the rarity in general. Of favorites I will go Alear, Chloe, Celine and Alfred. Not that I don't like Alfred, but I like the girls a whole lot more because I really like the Celine aesthetic with the puffy dress of a princess, and I also like Chloe because she reminds me of the old Pegasus Flyers from all the games that I kinda missed a little bit. And Alear, of course, because she looks like Sei from Fate Grand Order in a Fire Emblem aesthetic. Anyway, let's get into it. I really talked a whole lot about Engage, but actually really like the game, even though I still haven't played it, but what I saw looks very promising. You guys might wonder, when did I start playing the game? Am I an awakening new entry? I'm actually not. My first game was the remake of Shadow Dragon on the DS. Then I actually went back and played the Sacred Stones. And then I went and played the GameCube games. Actually, nice, we already got Alfred, okay. So Alfred is actually a rearmed hero, he's not even a permanent. So if you want Alfred, you should be going for this setup and get your Sparking, because Alfred gives the Arcane Lance. Actually, I need the Arcane Lance for my Hilda, so I even don't mind that I get one or more Alfreds, because I can use the extra skills for sure. Not that Hilda can use the flow and trace, but she can use the cross spore attack at least. So Alfred also has a very powerful skill, self-improver, as you can see, which gives him a lot of stats, basically for only giving him a very blatant weakness, which is magic. Will be a really cool showcase to do for sure. So this is actually another interesting thing about the engage banners, that probably each of them will have a rearmed hero, since it seems like ascended heroes come and go depending on the banner, if they are full of characters that are pretty much unknown, so they add an ascended hero to carry the banner in sales, I assume. For banners that instead have characters that are new and grounded, they do the rearmed thing, because the rearmed thing basically gives the new heroes banner a limited, which is of course a valuable target to chase after in most gachas in general. So actually, like the idea of making new heroes more valuable, because they're also the only banners that you can spark. Not the only ones, actually, there are also some exceptions, but they are in general the main banners which you spark on for free, because you get the chance to do it without the FA pass. So I actually like that they added such powerful tools into the new heroes banner. So I was talking about my Fire Emblem path, so to speak. So as I told you, Sacred Stones, where I really enjoyed Erika. Then I went and played Radiant Dawn and then Path of Radiance. That's actually a pretty funny story, because of course I was kinda young back when I played those games, so I didn't really have an idea in general of the series, but I really liked the gameplay of Fire Emblem, because I really was into the strategy sims, so to speak. I played a ton of strategy games, Imperium, Warcraft 3, Fire Emblem, so to speak, so I always loved those type of tactical base games that they did. Right now I actually don't play as many, I will be honest, I actually converted fully into a more RPG mentality, but if I can get the same experience that I got from older Fire Emblems in Engage, I will be more than satisfied. The problem that I had with Three Houses isn't that it was bad, but honestly, for someone that has played all three of the Persona games, the calendar system in Three Houses felt like they tried too hard to emulate the Persona 1 without understanding what made the Persona 1 good, which was the good, let's say, split between story progression and calendar, while the Fire Emblem one was directly, you have to do this, this and this before the next time. You cannot not do this, otherwise it is game over. That was kind of rough in my opinion. Also the gameplay and the technical side were kind of poor in Three Houses, so I'm glad that they also managed to make the game run really smoothly on the Switch. That's something that I also am kind of mad with the new Pokémon about, even though I really love the new Pokémon, but if the game runs flawlessly, as I've seen, I will be more than satisfied about Engage. For the story, I think that the story is something that I have to see for myself, that's the best way to put it. I know many people say the story is good, the story is bad, the characters are good, the characters are bad. When I played the Three Houses, I got this impression. The story is not that it is bad, but it felt incomplete. Why it felt incomplete? Not because the writing was bad, the characters are bad, etc. But because whenever you try to make split stories, like you have multiple routes, and this was very obvious in Fates, which is another game also that I played. I played all the new Fire Emblems except Valencia, because I didn't really. Actually, don't remember why I didn't play Valencia. I think because I sold my DS at the time, so I didn't even have it. But the split with routes in general, it is something that hurts the narrative, in my opinion, because you have to show two sides of the same coin and then you swap the perspectives. Whenever they did this within three different routes, Claude, Dimitri and Edelgard, I think it is pretty obvious that the main route, so to speak, was going to be the Blue Lions, because it was the most developed with characters, plotline, motivations, etc. It had the most complete ending, because there wasn't really any loose ending left behind. You have the Claude one, which feels a little bit... how to say it? It's like they added a new plotline to the mix that isn't really that tacked upon in the first half and the early second half of the game, which is kind of a shame, because I actually think that the Nemesis plot was kind of cool. And we got Rajat. I don't remember this character being too old, actually, but I might be wrong. So I am wrong, kind of. Okay, don't mind getting the Tarja version of Fates, but whatever. So, as I was saying, while the Edelgard route probably is the one that suffered the most, but everyone knows this because, not because she's bad. Oh, another Alfred, okay, we are getting two Realmed Heroes, and it's actually pretty nice. The reason the Edelgard route feels incomplete is because it was a last minute decision. They saw, they said, ah, okay, let's try and make the Crimson Flower route as well. And it came kinda weird. Then there is also the one with the church, but I actually don't even consider it a split route, in my opinion, because it is basically what if you do Edelgard, but then discover that Edelgard isn't to your taste. So it is a kind of a weird decision to add that route, but it's not that I consider it bad. So for me, if I had to rank my favorite Fire Emblems, without, of course, Engage, because I haven't played it yet. Okay, nice. We got Gregor. Gregor is from the Arcanea Banner, if I'm not wrong. No, it is from Awakening. Okay. Actually, don't remember a ton of Awakening characters. It has been a while since I played Awakening. Like, I remember my first Awakening playthrough. I married Lucina, I think. Pretty sure that I always went for Lucina on the first playthrough. Then the second one, I married Tiki. And I remember the first one that I had, I don't remember if it was Frederick or someone else, died really early, and I got really mad because of that, because I always play Classic, of course, it is probably one of the most enjoyable things, but I always find it funny whenever I have a character die for one of my mistakes, because it's not that it's funny, because you still let a character die, but... sometimes it happens in really dumb ways. Like, I remember it was, I think, in Radiant Dawn, where I had one of the Dawn Brigade members, don't remember the name, however, and basically I put her in front of a mage, thinking, well, the mage cannot attack this character. Then the turn after, my character just dies, gets deleted. And I was so mad that I opened the GameCube disc thing. If you guys remember how the GameCubes were, they had two buttons, I believe it was. No, three buttons it were. One that opened the little thing that covered the mini discs that you put for the reader. One to turn it off. And one, I believe it was to disengage the extra components, something like that. I pressed the button to open the disc. And it basically, it didn't even delete my save, but it made me restart the map. I did the map again, and the character still died because I did another dumb mistake that it was not using Mikaia to heal the character, because I was kind of stupid, but that's another story. I was kind of young, so Radiant Dawn really was an experience for the death of characters, so that's another story for sure. So, that's all to say that I'm very excited about Engage for sure. This Friday I will get it. I actually pre-ordered it a long time ago. I will try to actually complete it really fast. Actually, I had a ton of problems clearing games in the past year because with the channel, my life, etc., you don't really have the time to play as fast for some games. But Elden Ring, I did it also for God of War. There are some games that I kinda wanted to complete really fast. Another Alfred, okay, very nice, also new Pokémon. And I want to do it for Fire Emblem as well because I really like what I saw, and I do think that the narrative might be better than some people expect. Not that I have faith in the narrative, because everyone knows how Conquest was with the whole Ushidan attack by Corrin in Conquest, but I can expect something good from what I saw in the trailers. I think that there is potential for a cool story. Then we will see. Maybe I might be wrong, I might be right. It is a personal perspective on the story. I saw you guys whenever we did the Forging Bonds for Edelgard and so on. It was very opinionated on Edelgard as a character. And I think everyone is right and everyone is wrong. Everyone has their own opinion. And I don't think that there is a right or wrong in general that you can make out of a story. If you enjoy it, it is good. If you don't enjoy it, it is bad. If the majority enjoys it, probably it is a story that most enjoy, which isn't to say that it is good, but for certain it's not that bad in general. We will see. Okay, so it's actually funny that we will get to the sparking before I empty the tickets. So I'm thinking here, if you not get Allaire, which seems likely, I want to still use all the tickets because... okay, so the schedule should be like this. This week we have the Engage banner, this week at the time of recording, of course. Next week we have a Mythical, which should also be Engage. I am guessing it might be the girl that we saw in the cover All Around, Veil, I believe she's called, since she seems to be also a dragon, so maybe, and probably a good character, so maybe she is the Mythical. Then the week after we have the anniversary with the... Ah yes, the anniversary. I didn't tell you guys my Choose Your Legends. I will tell you in just a second. We have the anniversary with the Valentine banner. Okay, the... not really sure why I forgot that there is the Valentine that always is with the anniversary. And then the week after, if not the one after, there is the second Engage banner. Probably I'm expecting that they will do the... Illusia banner. Illusia is the country with Hortensia and Ivy. Why? Because if they do Rearmed again, probably they will do one male and one female. But maybe they will also do Brodia with Diamond, we will see. I kinda want Hortensia since I can start getting Hulls for her, since as I told you, Allaire, Hortensia and Yunaga are my favorites, so if I can get them really fast, I wouldn't mind. Since Hilda did her job. We had Hilda in the team for like 2 years, 3 years by now. I can kinda move on and go with another character for the story at least. I do kinda replace the character that I use for the story, gameplay, etc. But outside of the videos, I am kinda only using Hilda. Sheds, ok. Tristar. Ah yes, because the female Sheds is indeed a demote. Actually, I think I didn't even do her quest. Sometimes I forgot to do the quest for the free characters, but that's actually nice that we got one of the Sheds. Reading Sheds is a funny name for whatever reason. Not really sure why I find it so funny at times. Monica, okay, that's a 5-star that I can get behind. We are getting the 3 Ops characters in the same banner, that's actually kinda funny. Tons of characters for sure. Okay, so who are we getting for free? Allaire, for sure. As I told you guys, I want to get Allaire as my first priority. We got 3 Alfreds, I believe. One Allaire, one Rachet, one Monica, and one another, which was a 4-star extra as usual, but I don't remember who it was. Okay, so while we are done with the Sparky, oh, we can actually go for more. Okay, I don't think that I will go for more because there is the second banner and the mythical one that I can actually be interested in, so I will save up for that, but we will complete the ticket pools at the very least since seems like a waste not to do it in general. Hopefully we can get Serene or Chloe, but if we don't, well, that's four raid-ups that we have lined up. Alear, Alfred, Eddie and Lumera. And then whenever we get Serene or our dear Chloe, then we will do them as well as showcases. It's not that much of a worry if you miss a character that isn't Alfred, since the rest of them aren't limited, but I kinda wanted to get the engage cast in full if I could. The luck isn't supporting me, actually. To be honest, I got the limited character, so I can't even say that it is good luck in general, but it's not the luck that I might want for my intentions. That's the best way to put it. I'm actually glad that I also saved up a lot. The last two banners, which were the desert one, okay, we have Elise, Mark's sister, where the desert one and the New Year one, actually skipped both of those. Actually tried a little bit to get Sarah and the other character on the desert banner, but I failed, so that's another story. Let's see if the last two pulls give us Celine. Come on. Okay, we got Arthur. And the last pull probably will be a 3-star, knowing how this goes into my luck. In general, whenever it is the last pull, it is always a 3-star. Okay, no, maybe not. Come on, Celine. We have Regan. Actually got fooled by the hat for a little bit there, but that's fine. Okay, with all the ticket pulls, we got Alear, Alfred, and actually let's see who else by going into my barracks. Let's see. Obtain. Then we have to go down. I believe this is a mess every time that I have to do this, I swear. Okay, there we go. So we have Alear, Monica, one Alfred, two Alfred, Rutger, Gregor. Why did I call him Rutger? Who else would I think it of? Karel, that's the other 4-star upgrade, and another Alfred. Okay. Not too bad. We have one. Let's count only the real 5-stars, so to speak. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus the Sparking. 5 for how many orbs? I believe it was around 130-120. That's not bad. That's actually a good amount of orbs for 5 SSR, especially 3 limited, so it's not actually that bad either. I guess I will use Alfred, even though he was the one that I wanted the least, but that's good for any character that I get in the future that has a blue lance, so that's not bad at all. Ok my friends, maybe I will see you next week, or probably this will release next week, but maybe I will see you with the mythical red up if I like them, or if not, probably for the next engage banner. If the Valentine banner doesn't have engage and it is, I kinda want to go after it, but we will see. The anniversary for sure I will cover. Anyway, have the best of time playing engage. This has been it for me until launch. Remember to like and sub to support the channel, and to support the channel even more, remember to use the super thanks feature to give a donation of your choosing below your favorite Fire Emblem video if you want. I will see you next time. As usual, thank you much for watching, and hopefully you guys will have the best experience with the new games.